Lord be follow you. We were at a conference I was saying on Thursday with Prophetess Jennifer Leclerc. Who were the two people who received the blessing? You and Mrs. Sandra. I saw the seed, but they received the blessing. And my joy was so much. I was like, yes. Because if you truly love your people, you are happy when they are blessed. Amen?
Amen.
So trust is a very important thing. Do your assignment and leave. When they send you somewhere, don't go and begin to make connection between the church you are sent, the man or woman of God. It is not your alignment. It is not your relationship. Amen? Let me say Apostle Alexander has a church because he's somehow my closest partner. Or Apostle Paulette. And I say, oh, prophet, you want to go and preach there? And then he goes there, and then he goes and remains there and begin to call Apostle Paulette every day, for example. That's not the wrong, right way to handle it. Go do your assignment and come back home. And don't make it your duty to take the phone number of the man or woman of God who is a friend of your leader and begin to communicate with them. And now they are your confidant. You are going behind your leader's back and you are talking back and forth. It's the wrong spirit. It's not your friend. You were trusted with that relationship. It's your leader's relationship. Amen? Build your own confident relationship and leave your leader's relationship. Is somebody with me? We shouldn't open doors for confusion. Because there is a need of loyalty for the sons and the daughters. Amen? That your leader knows you are loyal. You are loyal to the vision. You are loyal to the house. You will not go and betray them to their friends. Amen? So you want to separate, you put a line. Separate yourself from your leaders and their partners. Is somebody being blessed? And then they can trust you with more. If your leader sees that when you come in contact with their partners or their friends, you want to go and become partners with those friends, they cannot trust you with access. Access is very important thing. Don't abuse access. Amen. Do your work and separate yourself. Don't abuse the access they give to you. The doors are going to be shut. Amen. And while you are doing those things, the person you are talking to is judging you as a leader. Because they are looking at you as a disciple. How can you leave your woman of God, a man of God, and you are coming behind their back to talk to them? So you are being judged. And the funniest thing is, leaders talk. Amen. They will call you and say, oh, this is your person is saying this, this, da, 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 da. So it causes confusion in the spirit. Amen. So you want to keep your own integrity as a man and woman of God and as a disciple. Is this blessing somebody? We are closing now. Has somebody been blessed by this?
Yes.
This is really key things for leaders. As you are rising up as leaders to work with other leaders and you'll be going out and do greater things soon. Please learn these things.
Amen.
Know these things. Understand these things. Because it will come back and hit you in the face if you don't do it right. Amen?
Amen.
Keep your plate clean. And be a woman of loyalty. Integrity, a man of loyalty. Integrity. Sometimes leaders of other churches will listen to you. As soon as you drop the phone, they're calling your leader. It happens. I get phone calls sometimes thinking like, please you poor, don't come and disturb my peace. Leaders talk. And sometimes they are lying. They'll be lying about disciples. I'm telling you. They're telling things about, I tell people, if somebody has been in your church before and did anything wrong, don't call me. I cut off those phone calls. As soon as they call me, yeah, evangelist Claire, if I ever say anything over it, I just say, I'm not available. I'm not available for foolishness. Deal with it and let me get to know the people for myself. Do not contaminate me. Because I want to be able to look at Mrs. Sandra in her eyes. I want to be able to look at everybody in their eyes. Not they'll be talking to me because somebody has said something and I'm looking at them, you know, I can't look at them. That's not good. That's not good. It's not the spirit of God. Amen. And last scripture, and we are done for today. Last scripture. 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 11 to 21. Last scripture, and we are done for today. Is somebody being blessed?
Amen. Hallelujah.
This is the kind of teaching that we need to be giving in leadership classes to really prepare the people. I think discipleship is so important so that we don't miss it. Amen. 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 11 to 25. Can somebody read it, please? Anybody who is there first can read it. 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 11 to 21.
Since then we know what it is to fear the Lord. We try to pursue men. What we are is plain to God, and I hope it is also plain to your conscience. We are not trying to command ourselves to you again, but are giving you an opportunity to take pride in us, so that you can answer those who take pride in what is seen rather than that what is in the heart. If we are out of our mind, it is for the sake of God. If we are in our right mind, it is for you. For Christ's love compels us, because we are convinced that one died for all, therefore all died. And he died for all, that those who live should no longer live for themselves, but for him who died for them and was raised again. So from now on, we regard no one from the worldly point of view. Though we once regarded Christ in this way, we do so no longer. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. The old has gone, and the new has come. All this is from God, who reconciled us to himself through Christ, and gave us the ministry of reconciliation, that God was reconciling the world to himself in Christ, not counting men's sin against them, and he has committed to us the message of reconciliation. We are therefore Christ's ambassador, as though God were making his appeal through us. We implore you on Christ's behalf, we reconcile to God. Be reconciled to God. God made him who had no sin to be sin for us, so that in him we might become the righteousness of God.
Amen. Glory to Jesus. Verse 18, look at verse 18, everybody. He said, all this is from God, who reconciled us to himself through Christ, and gave us, listen now, and gave us what? The ministry of reconciliation. Amen? Amen. The ministry of reconciliation. It means that every Christian, once you become a new creature, the number one ministry all of us have, whether you are apostle, you have an office, a title, or not. Amen? When Christ died and rose up, the first thing he did was, he said, go ye into all the world. Amen? So everybody is already sent. If you say, I don't have no ministry here, it's a lie. We all have the ministry to go into the world. Amen? And we all have been given our number one ministry. Whether you are a pastor, a prophet, apostle, a teacher, intercessor, your number one foundational ministry is the ministry of reconciliation. Reconciling means God has brought you in restoration, in relationship with God. And all of us are now called to bring others back in relationship with God. And we can do that in our homes, on the street, and everywhere. Amen? But the one key we must all have, as we close, when Jesus sent out his disciples, he said to them, even though he told them go, but then he said, you can go, but wait upon the Holy Spirit. Because it is the power of the Holy Spirit, the anointing of the Holy Spirit, that gives you the power to be able to testify about God. So you see, God is a God of process. He took them from the beginning, discipled them, trained them in between how to go back and forth. But even when he told them you can go, he still said, wait. God can give you a word saying your time has come to do this and to do that. And in between, there will still be a wait for this or wait for that. Amen? Your prophecy is not a guarantee to see that you are to live now. Wait upon the unction of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Does it make sense to anybody? Wait upon the timing of God before you move. Because if God gives the unction and the timing is right in the heavenlies, you will be able to encounter any demon and still prevail. That's what gave Paul the power to still prevail after they put him in prison. Amen. Is somebody hearing God today? Amen. Stand to your feet. Let's close. We can close there. Hallelujah.